Alpha or beta, I'm not sure. At a party, talk to this girl I know. Her boyfriend's there. She says, I'm feeling a little horny and my boyfriend won't find out. I take her to the next room and lock the door. Fuck the shit out of her. She starts moaning too loud, so I ram a pillow in her face. Tell her to shut the fuck up. Yes, daddy. We fuck like jackrabbits and pass out. Wake up at 3 a.m., realizing what the fuck I just did. I get dressed quietly, not to wake her up. Go straight to fridge. 2 gallons of milk, 3 dozen eggs. Take milk and eggs. Shut fridge quietly, while everyone passed out on the floor. Open front door, get in car, and leave. Oh man, my face when imagining a fit faggot tiptoeing out of a house with 2 gallons of milk and 3 packages of eggs. Be me, 13. Social outcast with no social skills, who everyone makes fun of. At a school party. Everyone's dancing, I just awkwardly stand there. Stacy from my class comes up to me. Asks me to dance with a smug look on her face. My autism kicks in. I just stand there and stare at her for a solid 5 seconds. Then just turn and walk the other way as fast as I can. Next day in class, overhear the girl talking with her friends. Hear her say that her plan was to embarrass me, but got embarrassed herself for being rejected by such a lowlife. My face and my autism inadvertently made me look like a Chad. Ha! Take that, Stacy. Go to temp agency. My agent is a fatty about my age. I introduce myself to her and take a seat. She starts plunging through all the questions she has to ask. She acts flirty with me and leans in, really close to my face. Not sure what she had for lunch, but her breath smelled like my protein farts. Notice a mask on her desk after putting up with this for about 15 minutes. Ask her if she could put the mask on because of COVID. She complies and asks if I have one. Tell her I forgot. Without the visible chins and breaths, she's not bad looking. It bothers me to no end when fatties flirt with muscular guys. Yeah, that happens to me all the time. It's horrible. That face when you realize that Hegel is the true mastermind, even from beyond his grave. That face when you find out about Hegel's occult interests and his connections with Hermeticism. That face when you realize that the dialectic is a magical spell. That face when you realize that Marx was puppeteered from beyond the grave by Hegel's terrible sorcery. That face when you realize the entire 20th century was controlled by Hegel magic. Hegel is the Antichrist. October 31st, 1831, Hegel is witness to have burst into flames and disappeared from this earth. Writings found outlining spirits corrupted, corruption by evil, satanic altar, books burned. Satanic Hegelian rituals outlawed, erased, dark triad 666. Going to the grocery store, at the fresh produce area. Parked my truck at near the store. Just minding my business, looking for quality produce. Girl calls out for me. I do not recognize her. Yeah, that's me, Anon, right? You look different, like a breath of fresh air. Tell her I've seen her before, apologize for not knowing. She smiles a lot, telling me how it changed me from the start. I wave at her. I also keep walking. At the self-checkout. Asks me if I've been interested about a membership lately. Tell her I don't know who she is, but it was nice to see her. Guy behind me tells me she knows me. Meanwhile, I was the only one there. Walk back to my truck, put it in reverse and drive home. Forgot my produce. Stop stroke posting and call an ambulance! We had 2 schizos in one. Oh, I recognize this one. Retard can crop, though. Once a year, for the summer solstice, I do my shave. The day before I go and get a haircut. And when I get home, I buzz everything as short as the electric clipper goes. I do face, chest, armpits, ass, legs, crotch, all of it. I then take a hot shower and clean off any stray hairs. The following day, I hit the gym and do a full, high-volume body workout to get a good all-around pump. I pop a few Viagra as I rush home, where I shave everything I buzzed the previous day. My whole body is completely smooth at this point. I should also add that I do NoFap and wear a chastity cage for a week prior to this. My wife takes it off for me to buzz and shave. I coordinate with my wife, who shaves everything while I'm lifting, and has also been wearing a female chastity device for a week. Her parents have our kids for the day, and we board the dog so the house is empty. While I'm shaving, she closes the shades and lays out a large plastic tarp over our mattress and some couch cushions that we arrange on the floor. Over that goes a bunch of cheap blankets that we buy a few days before from Target. By the time I'm done shaving, showering, and shaving my face, I'm completely smooth, still have a good full body pump going, and the living room is ready. We replace the light bulbs in the corners, red on one side, blue on the other. We put on some music, open up a huge jug of coconut oil, start oiling each other up. Coconut oil melts on contact with the skin, so we get extremely slippery. It's obviously edible, so you can lube up without making it so that you can't go back for oil later. At this point, I'm oiled, pumped, and the Viagra's kicked in. We're ready to fucking wrestle and massage each other, just destroy each other for the rest of the afternoon. Anything goes. All orifices on both of us are open for use. We clean up after a few hours, dump the tarpon blanket, and do it again the following solstice. Tradition. After 2 years of power swiping on Tinder, a cute art student messaged me and essentially declared that I was her boyfriend now. We then spent 8 months in a weird relationship, where she insisted that I practice having sex before she would take my virginity, and I had to spend hours silently pretending to fuck a pillow in front of her, while she sat on her bed, masturbating and criticizing me, saying that she would break up with me if I came. After dating for 7 months, she woke me up one night by latching onto me from behind and forcibly jerking me off to completion. Then she bit my ear really hard and whispered that I was disgusting. She then refused to speak with me for 3 weeks before breaking up with me, with a text message that also contained a naked picture of her. It's been a year since this happened, and she calls me once every few weeks to leave a voicemail apologizing for breaking up with me and insulting me in such a sexually charged way. I'm never dating anyone from online ever again. Oh man, I can't do this one because I don't have the rest. That was it for today. Thanks for watching.
And we say bye-bye!